In today's video, what I'm going to be doing is talking about how you can use Morningfame to do your keyword researching. If you never heard of Morningfame, essentially, that's the main thing that it does. It also helps you with being able to see your analytics a little better in case you are somebody that kind of get confused about seeing your analytics on YouTube, but it also gives you recommendations on what you should do and how your channel is performing. If you never used Morningfame before, you watch a little bit of this video, you wanna check it out for yourself, then look in the description box or look at the pinned comment below because I'll have a invitation code that you can use for Morningfame. So the first thing you'll notice is that they got four different tabs. One is topic, second keyword, third search, fourth optimize. But the first thing is to choose a video topic. So if you already have a topic in mind, you can go ahead and put that down right here. If you don't have a topic in mind, but you've seen a video that has inspired you, as it says, you can put the video link here. And if you don't have either one of those, then you could go down to create more of these. Morningfame is recommending that I create more videos like these because they're doing pretty good on my channel. Now, underneath this would usually be stay away from these because they have videos that are claiming they aren't helping my channel grow. I don't have that, so you can't see that right now. But underneath that is get ideas from channels close to yours. And you can see they have quite a bit of channels up here that are, for the most part, they're just channels that have similar videos to mine, but that doesn't mean that the actual YouTube channel itself is similar to mine. It might just have just one or two videos that are close. So you can see these down here and I can get some ideas from that as well. I'm gonna go ahead and start with a topic that I already had in mind, and I'm going to use by YouTube views. And you see that my main keyword by YouTube views, it is ranked not that great. I have a C, a D, a F, and an E, in which case I'll talk more about that in the next tab, which is search. But you can see right here, I got a 44 of a ranking. So that's pretty good as far as the ranking is concerned. The checks you see right here symbolize if the keyword is searched on YouTube. And then the second check is if it gets searched on Google as well. Right below the main keyword, you got other common keywords, which are great for larger channels, as it says. And then you got uncommon keywords, which are great choices for smaller channels. And you can honestly see that both of these have a pretty, like over here, even it says for the smaller channel, this is worse than the one over here, which just says by YouTube views. So for these other ones, if I actually want to see what it is, I can click on it and you can see quick lookup. And then now I can see that I have the rating for it. So if I want to go ahead and use this one anytime, I could just go ahead and go to step three, but I can do the same thing with this one. I don't have to use that for this because I can just go ahead and click to search. But real quick, you have common hashtags, you have uncommon hashtags, but hashtags really aren't that big on YouTube. So there's no point in even really worrying about these. And right below that, you can see the top ranking video. You can see similar videos right below it in case you want to get some ideas or some hashtags from it. But we're going to go ahead and go up and go to the third option, which is search, or the third tab, which is search. And you can see that I have by views right here, by YouTube views at the top. Right below that, I have suggestions. So if I want to make this longer, you can see that this helps give you more suggestions for it. I have last suggestions. I have used tags. I have my own traffic, and then you have search history, which would be any hashtags or keywords that I've used up here so far. And then you have favorites in case I wanted to, you know, favorite one, which case I'll do that right here. That would be a favorite. All these are ranked from what the current videos are, which is basically the lowest ranking one to the highest ranking one that's on the first page of the YouTube search. And then it takes your average of the last 10 or 20 videos that you've done, and then it goes from there to see how well you rank, to see if you can rank on the first page itself. So with that being said, between the last 10 to 20 videos, you know, subscribers are subscribers, so that don't really count. But the views in itself, and then the likes and comments, those are the main two that actually takes your average from the last 10 videos. And if you look down here, this one at the bottom, this is the gateway video. So that is this one right here, which has 1.5 thousand subscribers, only 700 views in 7 months. So I might be able to overtake this one. But as you can see, this F and this E is like, it's a good guideline to go with. But once again, as you just saw, you can still do it. It's just, you know, not in your favor. You want to do something that's more in your favor, you know, make life easier for yourself, not harder. Except for me, I like doing stuff like that sometimes. Okay, 2 karma. I'm doing relatively good in the ranking for this. All right, so you can see right here, I'm actually the person at the top, you know. So subscribers, views, the likes and comments, and the relevance. So it's saying that the relevance is at a 73. So really, I have a higher relevance, and the gateway person has a higher relevance than what is recommending. So yeah, I mean, this is one that where I'm doing pretty well on. So yeah, but let's go ahead and go back to my search history so I can find something that I can use, because I wanna actually do a new video so I can go ahead and get ranked and show y'all how to do the metadata for that, right? So let's go ahead and do 5 views on YouTube. We're gonna take this one and we're gonna go into the fourth tab, which is optimize your metadata. It says competition's too high. I'm going to go ahead and press continue step 4 anyway. And you can see right here, this pops up. It has a relevance of C, which is at 100% already. I didn't do anything, I just have the title. I have this keyword in the title and that is it. But I already have a relevance of 100 just by doing that. So what I want to do is put this in the description as well. And I want to make sure I have that in the tags. I didn't say anything about this when I was talking about the checks before, but any of these that have this little X right here, that means that it doesn't get searched on YouTube. So you might as well not even have them in your tags. Tags really don't do a lot. They really do hardly anything as far as, you know, getting you ranked in searches and stuff like that. It's more for if you misspell something. But, you know, you might as well have them up there. They're there, so why not? So I'm going to get rid of anything that has X by it, even though it has a relevance, some type of relevance to it. So I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of those. Let's go ahead and change this up to should you buy views on YouTube. I'm gonna go ahead and put this one. And I'm going to go ahead and paste that one down here so I can see the relevance. You can see the relevance right here is at 47%. So that's a good one. And let's go ahead and go down real quick so I can see pinned comment. So if I want to have a pinned comment, I can go ahead and just put this right here. Something I don't need to do right now. If I have a thumbnail, I could go ahead and put one in here, which I don't have one for this particular video, but because I ain't make the video yet, but just to upload something, you know, I'm gonna put a thumbnail up here, in which case you can see this one is changing your channel name. By the way, if you want to change it, you know, YouTube channel name, I suggest you check out this video here. But going back to this, I can see how well it does against these other thumbnails that are in the first, you know, page that shows up. So in essence, I would do a terrible job because, you know, I'm not really talking about what they're talking about. So people more than likely would scroll right past my, you know, thumbnail. If you are done at any point in time, you can go ahead and save this stuff, or you can just go to copy the clipboard. Like if I wanted to save all of my tags, I can go ahead and copy the clipboard, and then I can go ahead and just put them all down on my YouTube video. Now, even though I've shown you how to do keyword researching on Morningfame, you can also just do it on YouTube on its own, or you can do it on YouTube with TubeBuddy extension or vidIQ extension. And, you know, I'll make a different video explaining how to do both of those as well. So hopefully you found this information useful. If you did, I would suggest that you like, subscribe, all good stuff, as well as checking out this video right here that gives more detail about the other part of Morningfame that I did not talk about. So check that out. And as well, thanks for watching.